gentlemen, a splendid evening to you. I am your homegirl Kali, and we are right here at the Emerald Event Center celebrating with the Faculty of Law. Today is their law dinner, and it promises to be a very, very interesting one. Stick around, this is Let's Talk, and I am your homegirl once again, officially signing in.
It's another beautiful evening here in the city of Uyo, and trust me, we are having so much fun. It's a Faculty of Law Dinner's Record Night, University of Uyo, Unuyo, and we are right here at Emerald Event Center, Four Lanes, Uyo. This evening, different people will be awarded, people will meet together to eat, to have fun, and of course, to learn from each other. Right about now is the pre-preparation, the pre-dinner for this event. As you can see, all the I's are being dotted and all the T's are being crossed to make this event perfect. We'll be going to the red carpet to meet beautiful personalities and see what's happening in the law industry. It's Grand Prince Peter Pachulipopulo, official guitar, Sikana Basiasuko reporting for Let's Talk. Still the law dinner 2016, and of course beautiful people tripping in. Look at the beautiful hall, the magnificent decoration. Trust me, we're going to have so much fun. Now, while planning an event, there is this particular group of people you must not erase on an event. If not, your event would be maybe not worth it, trust me. But these people are so important during events. Ladies and gentlemen, just guess. You got it right. They are the ushers of this beautiful event. Can you walk down gracefully into the red carpet? Oh God, you don't tell me you are ushering too.
Yes, I am ushering. I'm ushering, but I'm so not.
You're not in black. I don't understand.
It doesn't matter.
All right, beautiful people. How are you doing this evening?
I'm good. I'm so much fine.
How are you doing?
I'm fine.
How are you doing?
I'm fine.
I'm fine. All right, I like your tie, I must confess. It's so beautiful.
Thank you, sir.
Huh?
Don't you like mine?
It's beautiful, but I don't like it. You're jealous.
Yeah.
All right, it's okay. Just by looking beautiful, and I have the special things for girls. Like, I have something for girls. I do something for girls everywhere I see girls. Do you know what that is? I'm not stop that. We don't want to go there, you know. All right, this is. Can I have your hand?
Okay.
Carly, you're jealous actually. I've never done that to you.
Okay. Should I do it to you?
No, ma'am, please.
Why?
It's improper.
Oh, improper, okay. So can you do it to her?
Gentleman. He wants to, but don't worry.
Don't be shy.
Oh my God, he wants to do it.
Go choose me like something when she's not. All right, let's go back to the main business, the ushering. So how does it feel like being an usher? Normally, when we're growing up, we saw ushers as people who were not responsible, who were not well-trained, who do not have a good background, just like people who do not have what to do. But in today, we have ushers who are intellectual. You have to speak good English, good communication skills. So what do you think about being an usher?
Okay, first of all, I would love to correct the impression you initially had about ushers.
Excuse you, initially.
Yeah, ushers are responsible people. Ushers are beautiful people. Because before you are being called upon to be an usher, that means you're presentable. You're not just ushering in a burial. Even a burial usher is presentable.
Yeah. Are you kidding? Burial ushers?
You're not serious.
They have ushers in burial.
So, as an usher, you're beautiful, and whenever you're called upon to usher in whatever event, just know it's an opportunity for you to meet people, to get to know people, and it's an opportunity for you to...
For the guys, get new phone numbers.
To be popular.
Okay, guys, I am so speechless. Ask me why I'm speechless.
Why?
Because I don't know. A very beautiful girl is standing.
You should say that.
What? No. I just want to say.
Did you hear that?
Oh my God, I'm not. Please, I'm not. But I can't just help but recognize this beautiful damsel, and she's looking so fabulous. Just check out that gown.
Okay,
Jesus. Okay, yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Oh my God, that's so romantic. Okay. Please, can you tell us your name?
Okay, my name is Victoria George.
Okay, so how please can you tell us?
Francis Scorbio.
Okay, so you guys are actually here for the Lord Dinner slash award night, and you have a lot of expectation. But before we go to that, I know you're not law students. Of course, you're not law students.
She's
so
a law student.
Oh my God! And I think she's your friend, right?
Yes.
Oh my God! So you came because of her, right?
Yes.
Oh my God! I'm so sorry. You actually strike me as a theater artist.
Like seriously?
That's okay. Let's do this. If in your next life, yes, you're given two choices, to be a law practitioner and to be a doctor or something, yeah.
Apart from law, what do you love doing?
Maybe I would have chosen medicine.
Oh my God, she wants to be a doctor.
So this girl is never concerned.
Oh my God,
I feel hurt.
Oh man, she's in her next life, she's going to be a doctor. Trust me, so she'll take care of you. All right, so we are actually here to have so much fun. Okay, as a law student, what are you actually expecting? You know, we believe that the entertainment sector is left for the art students. So being a law student, what do you expect? What are your expectations on this dinner night? And we know we're having lectures, so what's your take on that?
Well, the lectures, as expected, I think it's going to be very interesting.
Really?
You don't think it's going to be boring?
No, law lectures, like, it's never boring.
I think she's used to it. Yeah, used to boring lectures, right?
No, it's never boring. It's never.
Okay, and she's not a law student, and I know she's not a boring person. So what if you're bored? What will you do?
I'll just run away.
Okay, you've heard that. Thank you so much. We had so much fun talking to you. Thank you so much. I hope you have a very good, fun-filled, and non-boring lecture.
I hope so too.
Okay, people, guess who we have on the red carpet? You will not believe.
Yes.
This guy is a photographer. And you know, come and be claiming a law practitioner. He said his name is Savvy.
Snapshot. That boy.
Can you imagine? Come. Which one you like? To be a photographer or to be a law practitioner?
Seriously.
Well, the career I intend to pursue was law, but the talent I later discovered was photography. So I think I would rather do the two, own a chamber and own a photo studio.
No, choose one.
No, I will still go for law every day, every time.
Listen, see, I've never known photography to be a talent.
Photography is a talent. It's not a profession to me. Like,
you.
I'm talented in photography. I can take pictures. I'm good at taking pictures. I don't do it for the money. I do it for the fun. I do it for the fun I derive from it.
Okay, wait. So it's your passion, right?
Yeah, something like that.
I'm so happy this is recorded because we will have a photo session, without money. It's for passion, right?
No. When someone is talented in something, you have to encourage the person.
I quote someone
can paint. Okay. You buy such paintings and the person is encouraged to paint more.
Okay.
So
okay.
I take pictures and you pay me for it. I'm encouraged to take.
If you have a passion for something, you don't need encouragement. Just go.
Like you're good at talking and you're here talking.
Okay.
You like talking.
Okay.
You enjoy talking.
Okay.
And you're talking.
Uh-huh.
And you're getting paid for it.
Okay.
No. That one is not.
Right,
he won. Let's give it to you.
So now, seriously, very seriously, law as a profession and photography as a profession, which would you choose? I don't want to say both, because you could do this. Choose one of them.
Which I would go into after graduation or
yeah.
which
yeah.
I would
answer here, my
yes.
answer here.
Answer here.
This is law.
I don't like, generally, law. Law was just something we just wanted to do, and now we've done the law. We have the knowledge of the law. But photography is something I would love to continue.
Oh my God, photography
won! We won, cinematography won.
Maybe
yeah.
you can say so.
okay. We are right here for the law dinner slash
award night slash lecture.
Lecture.
Keep slashing.
We are slashing everything.
Yeah.
And we have lecture. I hope we are going to have dance.
The after party is going to be a billionaire's club. That's
we're
a different venue from here.
Okay.
All right. So what are your expectations for the dinner? What are you expecting? We've seen the venue and everything. Everyone is looking beautiful and the venue is looking splendid. But we're talking about the content now. What content do you have for us, especially those that are not law orientated?
Well, I heard like they had talked to the person giving the lecture and he had promised not to make it boring as usual. So all I want, all I expect is for the lecture to be interesting, to impact to both law students and non-law students, because this year we've expanded our horizons to accommodate non-law students. This government is a very friendly one, okay, accommodating non-law students. As of last year, I don't think we're accommodating any. Doing that, we're doing that for about 2,000 naira or thereabout, or strictly by invitation and stuff. But this year, we've made them involved other departments and faculties in the school. So I believe the lecture is going to affect everybody's personal life.
Okay, I have a question for you.
All right.
How many girls do you intend meeting this evening?
I believe most of the girls here are my colleagues, and I came here with a date, so I don't intend meeting anyone else.
We got a shift.
I'll cry.
She was, okay, officially, Lugoshi was crushing. She crushes in every guy. Like, every guy that comes on the record. I don't know why. But okay, it's been fun having you on the red carpet. I like your glasses.
Yeah,
I'll sleep for a while.
All right, no problem. Thank you.
I'm looking like savvy snapshot.
Yeah, of course, of course. Okay, now we want you to do something for us. We want you to say your name and what you do and encourage people out there to keep
watching.
Let's talk.
Like,
anticipate.
Them, a 400 level student of Faculty of Law, University of Uyo, a photographer, a dancer, a musician.
Oh, a dancer!
Okay.
Keep watching Let's Talk.
Oh my
god. Make it more dramatic.
To keep
watching Let's Talk.
Oh no.
Again.
Like shout. Like shout. Scream.
Keep watching Let's Talk.
No, like scream.
No, it's a dinner.
All right, thank you. Thank you so much. We had so much fun with you on the red carpet. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you.
Once again, right now we are at Emerald Event Center, and there are so many law students of which you are interviewing them on the red carpet, giving them dicey and intellectual questions to answer us. Let's really know if these law students are actually bright as they show us in school.
Surprisingly, most of them we've asked are actually not as smart as we thought they are. Some are actually like this, like they're actually very shaky. Some look just very smart, and some are actually very. Okay, so then the next we'll be going around asking several questions from different people, hopefully, actually. So stay tuned.
Yeah, the first question I'm going to be asking is, okay, I shouldn't say the question, right?
No, say it. We don't want somebody hearing it and just going to prepare superbly for it. So stay tuned.
Enjoy yourself.
All right, good evening. My name is Precious. I'd like to know your name, please.
I'm John Ayodeji.
What?
John Ayodeji.
Okay.
Yes.
Are you a law student or are you guests? Which of them?
I'm a law student.
Okay. You're what? You're what?
100 level.
Okay, that's nice. Okay. So it's the 2015-2016 law dinner. So what exactly are your expectations for tonight? Your expectations for tonight?
Well, this is my first year. So I'm overwhelmed at just this first sight. So I'm hoping that it's going to be a bomb, because that's been hyped. So I'm expecting it to be like that.
So as a 100 level student, what are your plans in Faculty of Law? Will you go into politics? Will you go into pageantry? Will you go into? Just tell me why
Faculty of Law doesn't have pageantry. They don't do pageantry.
2 years ago, someone from Faculty of Law went for Mr. Unio.
That's his own business. It's personal to him.
Okay, so what would you like to go into, politics or?
Well, it's academics first. That's what I look out for. Maybe when I get to year 3, when you are able to build your GP, or I am able to build my GP to what I need, I can be able to think about any other thing outside my academics. But for now, it's just purely academics. Yes.
Okay, so I have a question for you so that I put you at ease. Assuming two hungry lions are chasing you, assuming they are chasing you, what would you do?
Two hungry lions chasing me. For heaven's sake, I'll allow them to, because
he said he'll give up. We'll allow them to.
You're allowed to do what?
Sort of, I'll give up, but I'll run.
They are two hungry lions. Seriously, they are chasing you. Like, seriously, they're seriously chasing you. What are you going to do about it?
Keep running.
You keep running.
Keep running, yeah. See, when I'm tired.
And what happened?
I used to have this belief that God cannot leave me. So wow. He's a child of God. I believe God cannot leave him.
So if 200 lions are chasing me, surely there will be help from anywhere. Yeah.
All right, I wish you a lovely time tonight. Have fun. All right, thank you.
Joyce.
All right, it's 2015-2016 World Dinner, and there's been a lot of hype, according to sources, that there is supposed to be the best thing. We all know the hype, Sha. But the thing is, I want to know, what are your expectations for tonight?
As for me, Law Dinner has always been the best thing that has ever happened to any law student. Like, you feel it, you feel happy, you feel good to associate with your people, come out and sit down here, have a good evening and, you know, associate, listen to people give a keynote and they talk. So, and all those things that happen over the time, we know that Law Dinner in all the dinners in school is always the best. So I'm not expecting anything lower than what it used to be. In fact, I'm expecting something greater than what it used to be.
Your opinion, please. Wow.
Well, I think Law Dinner, if you've heard, if it's like the hype and the whole thing, I don't think they are wrong. I believe this is one. Law Dinner is the only faculty or in this University of Uyo that has a very civil Law Dinner, like a proper dinner. I don't think the hype is a lie. I think it's true.
Wow, we are informed that Law Dinner actually is the best dinner. University of, even better than Uniyo Night. Wow, like, that what you're trying to tell us?
I don't even think Uniyo Night is competitive anyway.
Okay, all right. Anyways, I have a question for you guys. Now, if your life was a novel, what would be the title and what would be the end? You first.
The life was a novel, what would be the title of the novel?
And what
and
would
how
the
would
and how would
the novel end?
If my life were to be a novel, I think I would title it, God, I don't know.
God. God.
Okay, I would title it A Shadow, and it will end like as if I'm not even around, because if I were to create myself, I know how it's going to be.
Wow.
Very surprising.
I just thank God that I didn't create myself. So I give thanks to the God that created me, because if I were to create myself, I would call it A Shadow. I would title it A Shadow, and it will end as if I'm not even around. Nobody would understand me, knowing my in and out. That's it. What I mean.
Okay. And I am right here with a gentleman. Please, sir, can you introduce yourself?
Ime Oro.
Sir, you're here for the Law Dinner and you're expecting a lot. I guess you're expecting a lot. So please, can you give us an insight of what you're expecting? And I came earlier and you said this is actually the King's Bench, and I don't really know what the King's Bench is. So if you can give us an insight on what that is about and your expectation on the event.
Friends, so that's a kind of chamber. I'm friends in the law faculty. They are made up of distinguished gentlemen. People like Onofio Luke, the Speaker of the House Assembly, is one of us. People like the current Public Secretary and Emebong Enobong, the PDP of Akwa Ibom State, is one of us. So you can count them. So we are distinguished gentlemen. So you know we have honorable members.
Okay, no wonder it's titled King's Bench. Bench. Of course.
Yeah.
Okay, so what are your expectations for the show or the event? What are you expecting from this? Because looking at everything, the venue is very interesting and very charming. The people in them are very interesting and very charming. But the content, we're talking about the content now. What do you think, or what are you expecting?
Yes, we are distinguished people. So as far as I'm concerned, this dinner is going to be filled with impact. The lectures, which we are expecting anytime from now, which I hope you are going to be part of it.
Okay.
You are going to see for yourself. Everything about it is special.
Very
simple. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir. And I actually had fun talking to you.
Oh, thank you. You're welcome. Welcome.
Thank you very much, sir.
You're welcome.
I hope you enjoy your dinner/award.
All right, people, it's still been the Lord Dina Awards and Dina.
Yes, 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 and we've had so much fun on the red carpet, interviewing a lot of funny people, serious people,
mind-blowing people, and of course interesting people, not forgetting the boring people.
Of course.
You know, they're all present in society. In a nutshell, the Lord Dina and Awards night is going to be very fun. Like, very fun. So far, it's been the red carpet, and we are like, wow, this is beautiful. Then what more about the main event? It's going to be amazing, and it's going to be beautiful, trust me.
Of course. Okay, officially, we are going to be closing up the red carpet. The main event is about to start, and we've had so much fun. So I think it's time for the learning and stuff like that.
Yeah, and listening. And of course, eating. Don't forget that aspect.
Of course.
Not forgetting that the after party is going to be at the Billionaire's Club at Worthausen.
And, personally, I'm going to have so much fun because I love party.
Dancing, you know, come on, you know how we do the stuff, you know.
We're going to be having so much fun. It's been fun on the red carpet. Oh my God, I had so much fun that I was about to cry. I don't know.
Okay, that's weird, that's weird.
I wasn't actually going to cry, I'm just saying that. Okay, I am your homegirl Kali Dukwe, and this is
Grand Prince Peter Patrilopoulos, officially Tansik and Abasia Sukwa. And I'm signing out. Special thanks to Precious and Off and On for coming to this event with us. Shout out to Ade for giving us a beautiful snapshot.
And I love Ade, oh my God.
Bobby, Namso, all of you are wonderful. And the Lord sends us a whole. We're wishing you guys a very beautiful dinner, awards, and of course a beautiful life after now. So from
thank
us
you
it's
so much, and from
Let's Talk, we say
making it weird now. Let's do it.
Let's
well
keep watching.
Okay, let's do it.
All right, let's do it.
Take 3, 1.
Keep watching Let's Talk. All right, bye.